You will hear from these astrologers the highly interesting and instructive story of why India got freedom on 15th August midnight. Midnight, remember this. It's only a nation which is armed with astrological wisdom that can choose a time like this. Otherwise, it was a very bad time. And they made the best bargain out of all this, and India has risen high, developed very well, unlike Pakistan, which chose freedom in the mid morning. So hear them.
Indian independence, which we are relishing today, was not easy. Centuries before, the world famous Golden Sparrow was being looted by Mughals and enslaved by Britishers. How much soever we say, we cannot feel the agony of Indians at the time. They struggled, they suffered, they sacrificed for more than a century beyond our imaginations, and then rebelled because they wanted independence. They only came to the point where finally Britishers got weak. Namaskar. With the blessings and guidance of our Guruji, Sri K.M. Raoji, I want to take forward the story of independence and contribution of astrologers in choosing time of independence and its effect on the future of our nation. Sir had been a close witness to this, as his father was a freedom fighter himself and was the prominent figure in the Indian National Congress. Now, the rebellion was at peak and the Britishers were scared. They were also very weak after the First World War. So they planned to leave India now. Mount Britain announced 15th August 1947 as the proposed date of independence. Pandit Surya Narayan Vyasji and Pandit Haridev Sharma Trivedi ji went to Dr. Rajendra Prasad and told that 15th August is not a very good date for taking independence. But Mount Britain refused to change the date for him. It was a good date for him as Japan had surrendered on this very day. No options for astrologers left. They were given the task of choosing the time of Indian independence. A big responsibility to make the best out of the bad bargain. We know that kabhi kisi ko mukammal jahan nahi milta, kabhi zameen to kabhi aasman nahi milta. So we had to find that how much aasman we can take for us. And then the question arose whether we choose the muhurta or muhurta chooses us. We were studying this in astrology. So what happened? The bhumi of sannyasis and sadhus is India. So here nothing should go wrong. So God gave the wisdom and duty to the astrologers to find the best time for the country to again get rebirth. And the time that was chosen by the astrologers was the midnight of 15th August 1947. We know that none of the official works is being done at night, but this was a special scenario. In this scenario, even the flag was hoisted at Lal Killa at 12 o'clock in the midnight by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. And you know that Surya Narayan Vyasji was the one who advised this at that time too. So what were the Panchang parameters of the day? It was a Chaturdashi of Krishna Paksha of Shravan Mas, Guruvar by Hindu Tithi in the Lagna Hora, Pushya Nakshatra and Vishti Karna, and the yoga was Sarvarth Siddhi Yoga. How this moment was chosen by wisdom of astrologers is responsible to predict the fate of our nation and natives is further discussed in this episode. So over to Anjuji.
Thank you, Deepa. Now see how all kinds of beneficence has been infused by our esteemed astrologers. The wise astrologers, they chose Vrishabh Lagna. ऋषभ लग्न विच इज अ फिक्स्ड लग्न, अस्थिर लग्न. अस्थिर लग्न इज ऑलवेज फेवरेबल फॉर लेइंग द फाउंडेशन ऑफ अ हाउस. व्हेनेवर वी शिफ्ट टू अ न्यू हाउस अगेन वी चूज अ स्थिर लग्न. एंड हियर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट गिविंग अ फिक्स्ड लग्न टू आर नेशन सो एज टू प्रोवाइड गुड स्टेबिलिटी एंड इट रियली वर्क. द नवाम्स चोजन दे चोज द डिग्रीज इन अ वे टू एज टू गेट मीन नवांश. मीन नवांश फॉर टॉरस लग्न कम्स अंडर द स्पेशल कैटेगरी ऑफ पुष्कर नवांश विच अगेन हैज सो मच ऑफ बेनिफिसेंस एसोसिएटेड विद इट. देयर वाज अगेन वन थिंग टेकन केयर ऑफ दैट मिनिमम प्लैनेट्स वर प्लेस्ड इन सेवेंथ एंड एट्थ हाउस. व्हेनेवर दिस काइंड ऑफ मुहूर्ता इज टेकन दैट इंश्योर्स लीस्ट hurdles and obstructions in whatever work we are starting. Then see the degree of moon. Moon at 3 degrees 59 minutes in Karka Rashi had just entered Pushya Nakshatra. Pushya Nakshatra is a Maha Nakshatra. It is called the king of constellations. It is a nakshatra of blessing and it is a most powerful nakshatra. V.K. Sridhar, in his very good book on Muhurata, has written so much about Muhurata and has compiled very well from the classics. In that book, we find that Pushya Nakshatra is extremely beneficial even in Kali Yuga. What to talk of other yugas, even in Kali Yuga, it works so well. There are lot many doshas. There may be lot many doshas in the horoscope and they are removed when the work is started in Pushya Nakshatra. Even when Pushya happens to be afflicted by a malefic planet, in that case also, it bestows complete success. Abhisht Karya Siddhi Milti Hai. Along with Pushya, the day happened to be Guruvar, the Hindu Var we are talking about. The Hindu Var happened to be Thursday, coupled with Pushya, forms a Guru Pushya Yoga. Guru Pushya Yoga, which is very good for learning. For learning, for starting learning Vedas, and then it is very good for trade also. The same combination of Var and Nakshatra forms Amrit Siddhi Yoga. Work done like nectar. And Sarvarth Siddhi Yoga, all desires are fulfilled when this kind of combination is there. And the best of all is, when independence was taken in Pushya Nakshatra, we got the very first dasha of Saturn. Saturn, which is a Yoga Karka planet for Taurus Lagna, giving us a very good foundation years to start well in the beginning itself. Now on to Manisa.
Yes. So I am going to share about independence taken in the Abhijit Muhurta as recommended by Hardev Sharma Trivedi ji and Surya Narayan Vyas ji. Abhijit Muhurta. 48 minute Muhurta. Every Muhurta is 48 minutes. Do ghadi. One ghadi is 24 minutes. And so every Muhurta is 48 minutes. Abhijit Muhurta 2 is 48 minutes. The midpoint of the Dinman and the midpoint of the Ratriman is taken 24 minutes plus on one side and 24 minutes plus on the other side. And we have the 48 minute Dosh Shunya Muhurta, Abhijit Muhurta. No wonder India got freedom at midnight. Now, where do we find reference to this 8th Muhurta in the 15 segments in Dinman and in Ratriman? Where do we find this reference? Now, Tulsidas ji writes in Ramcharitmanas about Lord Ram's birth in Abhijit Muhurta. Naomi Tithi Madhu Mas Punita Shukla Paksha Abhijit Hari Prita Madhya Divas Atishit Naghama Pavan Kal Lok Vishrama. Now we have definitely heard of Abhijit Muhurta in the afternoon. But what about midnight? Well, in Harivansh Puran, the birth of Lord Krishna is in Abhijit Muhurta at midnight. What is written in that? Daivakya Janada, Vishnum Yashoda, Tam Tu Darikam, Muhurte Abhijiti, Prapte Sardiratre Vibhushite. This is what Harivansh Puran says about Lord Krishna's birth at midnight.
Ah.
Abhijit Muhurta is extolled as the Muhurta for the coronation of kings and presidents. It is an extremely powerful Muhurta, and that is what was chosen for our independence. Yes.
Thank you, Manisa. As Anju and Manisa, they have told about the starting of the Muhurta and Abhijit also. Now, I will be telling about the Panchanga elements. So, when the day is concerned, Thursday, again, it is very auspicious as far as, you know, Muhurta is concerned. Here, the day lord, Jupiter, it aspects the 10th house of the independence chart, and it indicates the 10th house of the government. Here, Jupiter also is the 8th lord. It is there, the 6th house, forming a Viparita Raja Yoga named Sarala Yoga. And this yoga confers long life, success in all undertakings, overcoming the enemies, and widely celebrated. So here it also shows the rise in adverse situations. When we speak of the Tithi, it was Krishna Chaturdashi. And according to Brihat Parashar Hora Shastra, it is auspicious to have birth in the first part of Krishna Chaturdashi. It brings prosperity. The second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth parts result in the death of parents, ruining of the relations, destruction of everything, loss of wealth. So here our freedom falls in the first part of the Tithi, and hence, you know, it is very auspicious. So when it comes to the yoga, it is Siddhi Yoga. Siddhi Yoga brings in fulfillment, auspicious events, gains of wealth, and overall prosperity. When we speak of Karana, it is Vishti Karana. As it is also a neutral Karana, it personifies a hen and is associated with the challenges and obstacles. So the description is given there in Jyotisha Rudra Pradipa and Shambhuhora. So it also creates difficulties and hindrances. So in performing any of the tasks, our country is also facing so much of challenges, and then, you know, when compared to any other country. So here, this also works very well. Now, Hora. Hora is of Venus. Again, auspicious. It is also the Hora of the Lagna Lord, and it ensures prosperity and, you know, growth of the country. Now we speak of Chowdiya Muhurta. Chowdiya Muhurta, it is, you know, Labh. Normally, Chowdiya Muhurta is used for, you know, all agricultural purposes. So here it also shows the wealth and growth of, you know, all our endeavors, and, you know, and hence it is auspicious. Now when we speak of Dogati Muhurta, it is called as Nishita Muhurta. Nishita Muhurta, and it represents Brahma. In the Pauranik Muhurta, it is called as Brahma Muhurta. And in the Yoga Muhurta, it is called as Vidhatra. The nakshatra of this yoga is Rohini. And hence it is called as a Mahanishita Muhurta. So it all shows about the creation. It all shows about the starting of everything. And here, everything is started from scrap after the British left our India, looting most of our wealth. With the auspicious nature of the Muhurta, the nation was rebuilt again. The Lagna is also belonging to Venus, and this is explained by Anju very well. And here, the special yogas, when we speak of special yogas, in the Nabas Yoga, Sankhya Yoga is formed. Sankhya Yoga, the name of this is Shul Yoga, which is also personifies a thorn, which does indicate enmity, opposition, and, you know, it gives assertive nature, sudden rise and fall, and successful in war, valiant, and it creates obstacles in all the endeavors, as we witness. So from here, further, Monica will take you all in the journey. Thank you.
So as you see, the horoscope has several strong yogas. Five planets in the third house, along with the 10th Lord Saturn, creates the Sannyas Yoga. This yoga is formed in the third house of preaching. India will be the sannyasi, a guru, teaching and preaching to the world. The world listens to a person who is strong. So India had to become strong first. Today, it is a nuclear power. It has the third largest army in the world and third largest economy with purchasing power parity. Jupiter, the eighth lord in the sixth house, is in Viparit Raj Yoga, and our country is capable of coming out of any adverse situation successfully. The Trikona lords and 10th lord are together in the third house, forming Raj Yogas, also making India very good in communication, publication, television, media, creative pursuits, space odysseys, and these kind of lectures. The Gajakesari Yoga between the third lord moon and Jupiter gives it wisdom and courage. When the Lagna lord, sun and moon are conjunct, it forms a powerful yoga as Saraswati Yoga. This yoga is considered auspicious and indicates a favorable combination for knowledge, wisdom, and overall prosperity. It also has the Mahabhagya Yoga, as it is a night birth, and ascendant sun and moon are in even signs. It's a very lucky birth, as the 11th lord has more points than the 10th lord from Lagna, moon, and sun of India. Lagna also has 44 points, making it a very strong base. What would have happened if we had not taken the astrological guidance? Has it ever occurred to you? Well, we only have to take the example of Pakistan to see the real benefit of taking this birth time. Now, Pakistan declared independence on 14th August 1947, 001 hours at Karachi. So Pakistan has an Aries Lagna ruled by Mars, and the Lagna is in movable sign. The land of the country is seen from the fourth house. Fourth house has sign Cancer, again a movable sign, with four planets placed there: Mercury, Saturn, Venus, Sun, and Gulik. It has a connection with three malefic planets: Mars, Saturn, and Sun. Mercury is also in Mrityu Bhag. So you see, there is a severe affliction to the fourth house. The lot of trick houses, 6, 8, 12, have made a connection with the fourth house. Whereas in India, you would find it is the 159 houses which have made a connection with the fourth house. So this 6-8-12 connection has led to breaking of the country in 1971, when East Pakistan became a separate country, Bangladesh. And looking at the chart, more turmoil will follow in future. Moon is in Gemini, involved in a very bad exchange with Mercury, a Kali Yoga. And the fourth lord has gone to the 12th house from itself. As per our Guru Sri Kiran Rao sir, the connection of sixth lord Mercury with the fourth house shows the country will be plagued with internal strife and unrest, while a connection with the seventh house shows disputes and wars with other countries. Pakistan has had its share of both. Today, Pakistan is below India in almost all parameters. It has a military rule for majority of 80 years due to aspect of Mars on the 10th house. It does not have a flourishing economy. In fact, it's a bankrupt nation that has gone to IMF for loan. Its per capita income is 60% of India's and survives on imports instead of having a strong industry. The country also suffers from major law and order problems. It's a terrorist state and is known as a basket case with very little hope. So this shows very clearly what India could gain from selecting the best bargain out of a bad deal and select the most auspicious time. Now let's look at what the dasha at birth of Yog Karaka Saturn did for India. That was also decided by the astrologers based on the time. So Saturn, a Yog Karaka planet, is the 9th and 10th lord of the country. Saturn is placed in the third house of effort with Trikona lord Mercury and Venus. It's also conjunct with the royal planet, moon and sun. India got 18 years of Saturn Dasha. It gave India a strong base when the foundation of the country was laid. Key institutes were formed, alliances were formed, which gave tremendous benefit in times to come. The young and fledgling nation became a democratic nation. At the time of independence, there were 565 princely states and thousands of zamindari estates and jagirs. The favorable dasha of Saturn helped in completing this task quickly. Saturn, as the lord of the ninth house of luck, favored India. Each disputed area was won by India. And due to this excellent dasha, India got its constitution within 3 years of independence in 1950. It also became a leader and started the non-aligned summit and made a very strong base of institutes like Institute of Technology, Institute of Medicines, which later trained millions and provided world-class education to Indians. India continues to grow from strength to strength and will be the leader of the world and a beacon of life for a spiritual way of living, which is the only way to live and continue. Jai Hind.
Well, it was a good presentation.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Namaskar.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.